well, my third one and my fourth one. And I'm gonna put a teeny bit of salt right on top of here. I'm gonna squeeze a lemon into each one. One here, and that's it. I mean, literally, you're done with dinner. I'm gonna grab a plate and just plate one of them up for moi.
And moi.
And moi.
The two mois here.
And again, on a normal night, I probably would have
pasta or something.
No, well, not pasta. Because, you know, couscous is the rice pasta.
And
a meat, but yes, a veggie I would have. But again, it's late.
It's nine and no one.
Everyone's ready to eat, and we shouldn't. We don't. And I didn't have anything in the fridge.
Is it really like hot as in?
No. You want to try one? It's not hot.
Oh.
And then I'm just gonna try this pork.
Good. Really good.
So remember, there's some bones in here, but so on this side, I'm gonna just cut up the pork here. And this had mustard in it, sage, and there's a teeny bit of pink. When you press down, it goes down a little, but it bounces back up is how you know you're done. It was about 3 minutes aside because we were very thin ones. Okay, it's really good. The pork is a little bit warm, but I took one of the first ones. It's okay. Good, right? You can taste the mustard and the sage. One had the Dijon, of course Jake shows up for the taste testing.
He doesn't show up for the cleaning up and stuff, but he shows up for the taste testing.
So,
good.
So, salt, pepper, mustard, sage. Couscous with just some chicken stock, salt and pepper, parsley and cranberries.
And grab one.
And that's it. And I think that probably took 20 minutes to make. Maybe not even. So that's it for tonight.
And so those are the things. What did you do in 30 seconds or less? You took all those things. You breaded. Just to review.
Oh, to review. So the couscous takes 5 minutes to cook. You put chicken broth into 1 cup. It's 1-to-1 ratio, so if you're making 2 cups, you put 2 cups of chicken broth. Stop it right now, honey bun. And then, both of you. And then, get it to a boil, put your couscous in, just stir it up, take it off the heat, cover it for 5 minutes. And then for the pork, they were already thin cutlets of pork, but you can pound them flat if you want to. They're about a half an inch thick. I took, and instead of the usual breading, I just put mustard on each side of it, salt and pepper and sage, and then I put into panko breadcrumbs, which are Japanese, they're lighter, they're a little crispier, and then I pan fried them with about 1/4 inch of canola oil. Each side took 3 minutes. Of course, if you have the thicker chops, which I did see at the store today, that's gonna take longer. It'll be 5 to 6 minutes a side. If you have the really thin cutlets, I use those sometimes. They're used for like the veal cutlets that you get really thin. Those take about 1 minute a side. So these took 3 minutes, and then we just cut them up, fried them up.
Medium size.
And so we fried them up, each side, 3 minutes. Let them rest for 1 minute out here. Put a squirt of lemon, a little bit more salt, pepper, and that was it. The whole meal, done.
So good.
So good.
So good. Dun, dun, dun. So good. Dun, dun. I got you. Dun, dun, dun. It's summer.
I guess that was a hit then.
Yeah.
See you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
It's so good.